Hey guys, Chris again from ClassicVWBugs.com, and in this video I want to talk to you about another find that I got an email on this week, and something I'm really, really looking forward to go and see. It is a 1954 convertible oval window Beetle, and it's in a one family owned car, which is incredible to never be sold ever before. It's been in the family since it was new in 1954. I got the email from a guy who's in Connecticut, and he told me that he was looking to sell the car, maybe on our consignment services. And when he sent me the pictures, I was saying, well, instead of maybe consigning it, maybe I would like to purchase it for one of my projects. And he gave me the story. Basically, his mother had the car since up to a few years ago. She did pass away. He sent me some photos, and I was completely overwhelmed when I saw the pics. It looks pretty much all original. It doesn't look like it's ever been repainted. The interior looks absolutely original and untouched. I am expecting probably some rust repair that is going to be needed on this car, but the fact of the matter is that it looks all there. All the hard to find parts are there. It looks like it's a numbers matching car with the original motor. So 1954 oval window convertible with semaphores. This is a late 54. So this has the egg taillights on the back. That's when they started the little egg taillights in America at that time. And the egg taillight is probably one of my favorite taillights that the VW had in its lifespan. Okay, I'm going to take this camera with me, and you're going to come on another little joyride, and we're going to head into Connecticut and check out this car. And it's about an hour and a half into Connecticut, so probably leave sometime this morning and toot along and see this gem of a find. So who would have thought, again, we'd have been around here in the Northeast. Everyone keeps saying these are the Cali type cars that you find, but lately the Northeast has been pretty good finding some of these cars. So stay tuned. It's right there.
This is it. I just now found the original title to it.
Oh wow. Okay.
Wow, look at that. Look at the added lights in the front with the blinkers.
Oh yeah, these things are since I was a kid, these things have
the semaphores
fascinated me.
Yeah, the directionals, yeah. Wow, look at that.
The only thing that's sort of stumped us is, and I can't remember it ever being any different, But this rear bumper has been banged out like with a hammer.
Okay, yeah, so the deck lid can clear most likely.
Yeah, but it hardly clears.
Yeah.
But that's the way it's always been. So, oh, there was some add-ons to it on the Wolfsburg form. And I have a feeling this was put in the United States.
Look at these lights they put on. I mean,
yeah, I know.
Those are
directional.
Yeah, because the semaphores probably just aren't enough for some people. But these are cool, the eggs. Yeah.
Well, these have been disabled since birth.
Yeah, I was going to say, they most likely
They don't work anymore. Oh, really? They've never worked.
Yeah, we'll have to get
them. It'd be great stuff. If you get them.
Oh, yeah. Sure.
They've never worked.
The flower power there?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, she was a classic hippie. It's remarkable. But, you know, like I said, this car, my mother sold her MG when she was pregnant with my brother and I. And she had it the rest of her life.
Wow.
Now it's mine.
Kidding. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Because it was in pretty good shape before it went into storage. Now it's gone. It's going to have to be redone.
Wow, I can't believe the seats. That is just... That's nuts. Look at that.
I think 3 years ago when he got it started with one of his batteries.
Okay.
And it runs fine. We didn't want to run it because we figured there was rust in the gas tank and we didn't want to ruin the engine.
She's a great smoker. Cigarettes.
Looks like original motor.
It's got the A-chamber. That's good. The black with the red interior is always a very classic look.
Just a little bit of frame rod.
You can take that out if you want.
That's expected. Years old. We got your common rust areas right here in the back of the heater channels. Check that out, original headliner. Very cool. Still has no wrinkles. Look at these seats. I bet you these would clean up with a little elbow grease.
Wow. I might reuse them.
Looks like the mice have made a little bit of a condominium, but that's okay. The tub is actually pretty good, considering. As you can see, the support rails are completely gone. Floors don't seem too bad, but the rails and heater channels look like they're gonna need some major work. The rear wheel wells. This area actually looks pretty good.
It's pretty good. Semaphores haven't worked in a while. This is why they have some aftermarket blinkers on there or something, just so they can show directional. Back here. All the parts that's needed to put it all back together, so that's a plus. Convertible parts are a little more rare to come by. Car's gonna need some heavy duty work, but overall it's a hell of a find to find on the East Coast. Somewhat of a survivor. Doesn't look like it's ever been repainted. If there was anything repainted, it was the passenger's rear fender. That is not an original fender. Back in the day, these aftermarket fenders were pretty much exact. The reason I was able to tell the difference is if you look under this fender, as opposed to the driver's fender, you can tell that there's no dimples in between the bolt holes on this fender, which would have been correct for an oval. On the driver's fender, there's dimples in between, and I can also see welded up taillight holes that usually come above on an aftermarket fender, so they welded those up and made new holes for the egg tail lights that naturally sit lower. Motor is actually original to the car. This is a November of 54 bug. This is why you have the egg tail lights. Late 54, early 55s had the eggs. The motor does have a little bit of end play, but I bet you with some fresh gas this thing would actually run. So actually it turns freely, so but most likely do a rebuild anyway. Yeah, how cool is that?
convertible 7-4s. I don't know if you guys can see this. I think the Speedo has been rebuilt. Dashboard seems to be intact. It's got a radio delete on it, which I like.
And this is an interesting speedometer. It doesn't actually have the arrows for the turn signal in the center there by the miles per hour. It's just a circle. But it's definitely a later Speedo because 90 is at the end of the speedometer for the speed there. It would have been to 80 for these years. And it would have been a clear needle on the Speedo, not the solid white ivory.
That's nice. These seats are great. I mean, there's not a tear in them. I'd almost keep them. We got the correct convertible deck lid, which is very much sought after.
That's sweet.
So it's got the correct four-tab hood, it's got the correct bolt holes underneath, the correct prop position for the hood as well. So I think we're gonna make this guy an offer and see where we go from there, guys.
I gotcha. It's all good.
This is the original manual. Check this out, very cool. There's the Mula Shmula. You wanna count it?
Okay, so we found a really nice find, 54 oval window convertible. Very rare to find, low production numbers. You gotta think they made one convertible to every 100 sedans that were built. So to find them in this shape, all complete, and an original numbers matching, all, you know, straight across the board, is something that you can't pass up. So we got it for a great price, and we're on our way back to the shop. So. All right, follow the restoration online. Got any questions? Chris@classicvwbugs.com or visit my website, www.classicvwbugs.com. Peace.